What if preventing cognitive decline as you age is easier than you think? Now, research says it is, but here's what's surprising. It's not about memory pills or supplements. It's about movement. Hey, I'm Hitch. I'm 76 years old, but my latest blood work says that I'm about 50. Longevity science isn't a hobby for me. It's a passion. It's all I do, all day, every day. As we grow older, cognitive decline is often treated as inevitable, but it's not, at least not entirely. In this video, we're going to look at what actually happens to the brain as we age, what changes, what breaks down, and why those changes affect memory, focus, and decision making. Then we'll look at what the research shows exercise can do in response, not supplements, not brain games, movement. I'll walk you through how different types of exercise, aerobic training, strength training, and high-intensity work affect the brain in different ways, and why combining them appears to offer the strongest protection against cognitive decline. Finally, we'll look at what's happening inside the brain that makes this work, the biology behind it, and why exercise may be one of the most powerful tools we have for preserving cognitive function as we age. As we age, the brain changes, subtly at first, and then more noticeably. The memory begins to fade. Decision-making slows down. Reaction times aren't as sharp as they once were. These aren't just little conveniences. They're the result of physical changes happening inside the brain. And it isn't just about forgetting names or where you left your keys. It's about the brain itself shifting, rewiring, and in some areas, deteriorating. One of those changes happens in the hippocampus. It shrinks. This region, vital for memory, loses volume over time. The prefrontal cortex, responsible for decision-making and problem-solving, also deteriorates. Even the brain's white matter, the connective tissue that links different regions, starts to break down. That loss weakens communication pathways, slowing thought processes, and making multitasking more difficult. These structural changes affect more than just memory. They impact focus. They influence emotional control. They make it harder to adapt, react, and engage with the world as we once did. But here's the good news. Cognitive decline is not inevitable, not entirely. Science shows that exercise can slow down or even reverse some of these effects. Movement isn't just for the body. It's a trigger for brain growth and repair. So what happens when we move? How does exercise reshape cognition and memory? Let's dive into the science. The research is clear. Exercise improves memory, speeds up thinking, and enhances overall brain function. And these benefits aren't fleeting. Some last for years. Aerobic exercise is where it starts. Walking, running, swimming, they all increase blood flow to the brain. That means more oxygen, more nutrients, less inflammation. And crucially, it stimulates neurogenesis, the creation of new brain cells. The hippocampus, your memory center, benefits the most. Memory sharpens. Mental clarity improves. Cognitive decline slows down. But creating new brain cells is only the beginning. High-intensity interval training, or HIIT, supports the survival and the connection of those cells. It plays a key role in long-term brain adaptability and memory retention. Resistance training offers another crucial advantage. Stronger muscles are linked to a lower risk of brain atrophy. The takeaway? Strength training doesn't just preserve mobility, it protects the mind. But the greatest impact comes from a combination of all three. Multi-component training blends aerobic, resistance, and flexibility exercises. It activates multiple brain regions. It protects against aging. It creates the strongest foundation for lifelong cognitive health. So, how does all this work? What's happening inside the brain to drive these changes? The link between exercise and brain health isn't just a theory, it's biology. Physical activity triggers powerful physiological changes that shape cognition, memory, and brain function itself. Each type of movement plays a unique role. Together, they create a symphony of benefits. Neuroplasticity is key. The brain's ability to reorganize and form new neural connections is what keeps it sharp. High-intensity interval training, or HIIT, excels in this area. It challenges the body, but the real magic happens in the brain. A study from Aging and Disease in July 2024 found that HIIT-mediated changes in circulating levels of brain-derived neurotrophic factor, or BDNF, and cortisol correlated with improved hippocampal dependent cognitive ability. BDNF fuels neuron growth. It strengthens pathway. It primes the brain for learning and memory retention. Cortisol, often seen as harmful, can actually aid in stress adaptation when properly regulated. Together, they create an environment where the brain remains flexible and adaptable, even as we age. Strength training works differently. It builds more than just muscle. It's associated with preserved brain structure, supports mitochondrial health, and may help reduce the risk of cognitive decline. Think of the mitochondria as the power plants of the cell, essential for energy production. One study states that higher skeletal muscle oxidative capacity is associated with preserved brain structure up to over a decade, particularly in areas important for cognition, motor function, and sensomotor integration. The takeaway is clear. Strong muscles mean a strong mind. The connection between physical strength and cognitive resilience is undeniable. Aerobic exercise enhances circulation. Blood flow increases. Oxygen and nutrients flood the brain. This process helps regulate inflammation, minimizes oxidative stress, and supports neuroplasticity. Studies show that aerobic workouts improve working memory and executive function. They keep the brain energized. They keep it resilient. But there's more to it. Cardiovascular activity also helps regulate blood sugar levels, reducing the risk of conditions like diabetes, which are linked to cognitive decline. A well-nourished brain is a high-performing brain. But no single method stands above the rest. Multi-component training, blending aerobic, strength, and flexibility exercises, support cognitive function across multiple domains. It doesn't just activate single neural pathways. It engages multiple systems at once. This approach doesn't just strengthen individual brain functions. It may help support the brain against aging itself. It can contribute to keeping the mind sharp and the body agile. If longevity and preserving your health span is important to you, and you're looking for the latest interventions, protocols, and discoveries in longevity science, I've created a Skool community just for you. It's called the Longevity Alliance, and it's absolutely free. Inside, you'll find robust discussions, free lessons, and even the opportunity for group coaching. Just check out the link in the description. Cognitive decline isn't just something that happens to us. It's something that we actively influence. The brain responds to how we live, how we move, and how consistently we challenge it. Exercise doesn't just support brain health. It alters the trajectory of brain aging itself. It preserves structures. It maintains communication, and it creates conditions for resilience, adaptability, and long-term function. Because the brain you have at 80 is being built by the habits you have today. Now, if you want to go deeper on any of this, join the Longevity Science right here. It's completely free. Okay, that's it for me. I'm out of here. Catch you next time.